Hi, it's Emily from Bite Size Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. Today's video is another installment of my interview with vegan activist Gary Yourofsky. With the overwhelming enormity of unnecessary animal suffering in the world, it's easy to lose hope that any significant change will occur anytime soon, if at all. In this interview segment, I ask Gary his thoughts on whether we will see a vegan world in our lifetime, and then I share my thoughts on the matter before asking for yours. So here's to a vegan world.
Do you think that there will come a day when veganism is the norm and meat, dairy, and egg eaters are in the minority? And if so, how long do you think it'll take to get there?
Depends on which day you ask me. You asked me after last week's lectures. I had 4 in Charlotte, I had 3 in Rhode Island, all but 2 students out of more than 300 were fabulous. Only 2 gave me a negative response, so I'm going to say, man, soon. Sooner rather than later. But you ask me on a bad week where I have more people arguing or people want to fight with me, or maybe I saw something horrible that just was exposed, and I'm going to end up saying, no, I don't think it's possible. But all I know is that injustice can't last forever. Animals will obtain their freedom one day. When? I wish I knew. There was a time I never thought it would happen in my lifetime, but considering what's going on in Israel right now, I'm not so sure about that. I'm still 44, so we still have a lot of time left for liberation to happen to animals on this planet, and I think it's going to happen in Israel first. In fact, I'm quite positive, and I'll tell you what's interesting about that is I've been asked by a lot of people in Israel, how come here? Why us? Well, it's supposed to be God's holy land. Seems to me a perfect place for speciesism to be destroyed, for animals and humans to get along peacefully. So it's going to happen there first, and from there, it's going to spread like wildfire. And once the majority of people start doing it, and they're moving their way up. They are moving their way up day after day, thousands and thousands more people every week, every month. Tal Gabol was just on the Big Brother Israeli show. A survey said that she converted 80,000 people while she was on this show for a few months. It's happening there, so I definitely think it's possible. Again, injustice can't live forever, but it took 400 years to convince white people in America not to own black people. You can see why this is taking so long.
I hope you enjoyed hearing Gary's thoughts on this matter. I would like to believe that a vegan world could occur in my lifetime. Like Gary, for me, there are days where it seems like a viable possibility, and other days, a distant, unattainable dream. What I believe is of utmost importance, though, is that we do not lose hope, and that we never doubt the impact that even one person can have. Whether you love or hate Gary, you have to admit that he's proven how big of an effect one person can have. You have a voice and can speak for those who cannot speak for themselves. You can create change. You can make a difference. I know it's overwhelming and sometimes the battle seems far too large. I've had and continue to have my own struggles with this, which I shared in my speech about my journey into activism through Bite Size Vegan. But change is possible. Just take action, whatever action that might be. Now, if you're wondering what would happen to the animals and industrial agriculture and farmers if the world were to go vegan, check out this video where I go over those logistics. Trust me, it's a good problem to have. Now, I'd love to hear from you on this topic. Do you think the world will ever be vegan? Will animals ever achieve the freedom that they so richly deserve? Do you think that this can happen in our lifetime? Do you struggle with feeling overwhelmed by all of the suffering out there? Let me know in the comments. I really do value your insights. Now let's close it out with Gary.
Gary, I just want to thank you so much for giving us your time. And I've been asked on behalf of so many of my viewers to just thank you for everything that you do. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Keep on. Everybody pass your stuff around. It's tight stuff. Honestly, bitesizevegan.com. Share it.
Give the video a thumbs up if you liked it, and please share it around to spread the message. Stay tuned to the Bite Size Vegan channel for more installations of my interview with Gary. I'll also be posting bonus questions and footage that didn't make it to the channel in the VIV area of BiteSizeVegan.com, which you can access for free by clicking below. And for even more behind-the-scenes action and great discussion of all things vegan, join us on Patreon in the Nugget Army. If you're new here, be sure to hit that big red subscribe button down there for more awesome vegan content every Monday and Wednesday and some Fridays. I would love to have you as a subscriber. Now go live vegan, take action, create change, and I'll see you soon.